integral part of the Kubernetes test infra. So Kubernetes test infra basically deals with whenever there are PRs, the testing, the SIG testing unit is mainly working with on the prow. So they handle a lot of things like scheduling your test jobs, updating issues. When I mean updating issues, I talk about adding, removing, adding labels to your PRs or issues, merging those issues, automatic merging of those issues is possible. A lot of tasks and checks are run against, executed against your PRs that you send. Another thing that it does is it responds to a lot of GitHub events. There could be timers for periodic events and a lot of manual commands that are given to you that actually trigger a lot of your these jobs and add labels to it. So you do not have to manually go and add those to your repository, but you can run simple commands and that will do it for you. So next I'll go through the flow, how it does it. So this basically, so like I said, it is very integrated, listens to the GitHub webhooks that are there. So on, there's one side to it is the GitHub, and the other side is you have a Kubernetes cluster which actually has your entire prow set up there. So whenever you trigger any event, like you add a command like test or run test or whatever your the different commands that are available to you to add labels, so that is the event that you'll trigger on your GitHub. So through webhooks, it'll go to the GitHub event. Then there is a server that is there, which is hook. So these are all Kubernetes controllers that are there on this side of the box. So it'll send that to the hook server. Hook server will deserialize your payload that comes from the GitHub, and it will also send it to the Plank. So Plank is another controller. So what hook will do, it is will create a job, a prow job for you. And all the prow jobs are sent to the Plank, which is more like a scheduler that will schedule your jobs on the Kubernetes side of it. And Tide and Horologium are the other controllers. So Tide is for merging of the PRs. So that is a controller that handles PR merging. And Horologium is for the periodic tasks that you have, like the cron jobs or all those things. So whatever you want to run on periodic basis, that will be handled by Horologium. So the Plank will then schedule a Kubernetes pod for you if your prow job is not already scheduled. And then it'll check out your PR. And so these are all basically just your Kubernetes pods that are there. So it does everything as a Kubernetes pod, and then it'll execute all the tests. And once they are executed, the prow jobs finish, it takes down the exit code, whether the job was successful or not. And the success code is then sent to DEC, which is another component, which is basically your dashboard or the UI to, for you to actually see what happened behind the scenes. And the status, it also returns to the Plank, which again updates, sends the result back on the GitHub event, and your PR will be updated. So if it was like a label that was you had issued command for, so a label will be attached to your PR. Then there is a syncer, which is another component that will clean up a day after all the jobs that were old jobs, that will be cleaned from the Kubernetes cluster. So that is one workflow where I'm talking about more about the how the jobs are scheduled. The other is the GitHub plugins, how they work. So GitHub has a lot of automation plugins that are provided, like I mentioned, the slash commands. So what this is, like, again, the same event flow is there. So whenever you send a GitHub event and then it goes to the hook, hook listens, deserializes the payload and sends it to the plugin. So the different plugins which are configured, so like for instance, there is a work in progress plugin which attaches work in progress labels to your PRs so that they are not merged accidentally, or because we are dealing with automatic merging, so they are should not be merged. So that is how it filters out those PRs. So that'll attach a label. There's another for retest. If you want to retest or run the all the unit tests or the integration end-to-end tests, so there's another plugin for that. And depending on, so after, once the request is sent to the work in plugins, it is again sent back to the GitHub, and the things are done. So some of the commonly used plugins are, so approved, so that, so when you have, so it actually reads your GitHub owner's file. So depending on the owner file, so only the owners of that project can actually, if they just give the command slash approve, the PR is approved and it can is ready to be merged. For all the reviewers and everything, anybody else who is aware of the project and who is good enough to respond, so they can have a LGTM to approve label, then you can assign. So if you have a pull re- request and you want to assign to somebody. So if you are not, so this is a very good example where I said that GitHub permissions are very granular. So suppose I am new to a project, I cannot, unless I have all the permissions, I cannot go and attach a reviewer because I do not get the option to add reviewers there. So you can actually assign it to somebody if you know it, or it will actually, so again you can add a file where you, it will suggest you that you can add. Then again, so this is, that is the blunderbuss, so it actually checks the owner's file and adds, assigns automatically to reviewers. Then needs rebase, so again if it's automatic merging, so this plugin will actually, alert, it will add a label that it needs rebase. And there are many more plugins you can actually check out on the actual Prow website, the plugins that are there. So in production, you can see it in a lot of projects, open source projects like Istio, OpenShift, Origin, Kubeflow. All these projects are actually using Prow as their CI/CD tool. Next, like I said, so fine. So we are good that on Kubernetes, on big projects of the scale of Istio, OpenShift, Origin, Kubeflow, these are working fine. But what if you want to add this to your own project? So suppose you have like, so I see a lot of Gluster folks, so suppose you want to add it to your Gluster repository, what you need to essentially do is, first thing that you need to do is you need to bring up a Kubernetes cluster. So I'll be demoing this shortly after this. So I'm doing it on a local setup, so I'll use Minikube to set up my Kubernetes cluster, but you can actually deploy it on OpenShift as well, so that's not a problem. Then you need to create, so you can create a GitHub bot account for your entire organization. So once you have the GitHub organization bot account, and then you will have to configure two secrets for it to be able to talk to GitHub. So the two tokens are the HMAC token and the OAuth token. HMAC token is just for validating the webhooks that it's coming from the repository. And the OAuth token is for the read and write access to the bot to actually write comments for your PRs or issues. Next, you will have to spin up the Pro components, those are like the ones which I discussed earlier, the plank, the hook, all those components. So for that, you need to have a simple manifest config file of Kubernetes. I can show you the example of this. I'll show it later while I'm demoing it. So that's the config file. There's one that is already available on the Kubernetes repo, test infra repo, one is which is already available, the link to it is there. If you do not want all the components, you want to skip something, you do not want tide, you do not want auto merging for you can skip out those. Otherwise, you can have the complete, which is there. Once that is done, we actually add webhooks so you'll have to configure webhooks for your GitHub repository. That's a very easy task, I'll just demo it again. And whichever plugin, so the plugin list is very exhaustive, so probably you do not want all the plugins. So you can configure whatever plugins you want by just adding a plugins.yaml file to your repository. And also the different kind of jobs that you want, so that is again configurable using config.yaml file in your project. If you want to read more details about each of this, there's a very nice documentation on Prow getting started, so that is there. Next, I'll first demo. So is the font clear? But this is the video I am playing right now. I can show you later on the live thing. So the first step is that you have to bring up a Kubernetes cluster. So like I said, I am using Minikube for that, in my case, to set up the cluster. Next, you can create a GitHub bot account, and you have to create GitHub secrets. So first, you have to create an OAuth token. OAuth token, again, you can get it on your OAuth token is again, you can just on your GitHub, you can settings, you can get the token for you. And the other, so next you need an HMAC token. For HMAC token, you can use any random number generator, or you can use OpenSSL random hex generator. It will generate an HMAC token for you. Next, you have to deploy Prow and its components. So this is the file so I've created two tokens for me. One I've stored in tokens, hmac.token file. The other one I've OAuth token that I've stored in OAuth.token. So I'll create secrets, so I'll use the kubectl command default file which is there for the Kubernetes manifest file. I can show you how what that looks like. So this is what it actually looks like. So this is the starter.yaml. So it has everything like the resource definitions for your custom resource prow jobs, then for your hook deployment, for plank. So also whatever you do not need, so this is the file that is already available. You can use the default one if you want the complete configuration by default, or if you want to customize it, this is the place you can actually do it. So that is how you will just specify kubectl apply, and whatever manifest files you want to give, you can do that. Next, so this deploys your this. So like, so I've deployed that script that I had written. So it has created and it has started all the services for me. Next, I will enable the webhook for my repository. So this is the sample repository that I have created. So under settings first, so like I said, the bot that we'll be using. So this is the, you have to give the bot the collaborator permission to your repository. So if it is already configured, you'll have to share that somewhere and then you can give that. And then you have to configure webhook. So this is the payload will be where your hook service is running. The payload for that URL is that. Your content type is application JSON and the secret should be the HMAC token there. Then you have to enable plugins for your repository. So you've already added webhooks for your plugin. So this is how, this is the simple YAML file. So you just give the names of the plugins that you want to configure. This is, and it'll enable the plugins for you. Next is the job. So this is the YAML file that I've created. So I've just added one job that will test all the unit tests in it. So that is what I've defined and it'll do that. Once I've said this, I will actually have to update all the config files that are there for the plugins in this. So there's kubectl command that will actually update all my pods and everything, deployments. So then you can see, so after I execute that, these all are updated and these are all the pods that have been created. And these three services, hook and deck service, have been started for me. So next I'm using UltraHook to actually listen to the web. So this is then I check, so this is my repository. I've modified these files, I've added those. I'm committing the changes and I'll push it. So once I'm pushing it and so the code has been pushed. This will trigger, once I push this, so this will trigger a webhook which is there. So the new PR, once I create it, it'll be triggered. So this is the new PR that I'm opening. So I've opened the PR, and if we go back on the webhook where I started, so all the, so it has received all these events which were fired. So when I committed, when I pushed and opened a new PR, so those were added. So I had configured size plugin in my, which actually checks what is the size of the PR, and also the unit test job that was auto triggered because it was a pre-submit job, so it has triggered the unit test. And you can actually go on the dashboard and that will be updated, so you can actually check all the jobs that are there for you that have been executed are available on the dashboard. So that's it for the demo.
What sort of information is there on the dashboard?
Okay, so I can show you the dashboard. So dashboard has, so this is my PR number, so this is the repository that I'm copying of, and this is the first one that comes with the echo test. When I actually configure it, then this is my repository, this is the PR for which it was updated. So this was hash one PR, so the one that I showed was hash three. So the job was unit test, it was started, and the duration for which it ran. So this is the information that is there. And next, what we are doing at what we are doing with our team, developer tooling team for our OCO OpenShift IO project, we are using EEKPRO plugins. That is our own customized version of it. So we've actually taken a lot of things that are common from the Pro plugin, but we've customized a lot of things for our need. So one of the things, so we have different plugins that are there. There's Test Keeper, PR Sanitizer, Work in Progress. So Test Keeper, actually, we have enforced certain rules for your whenever a PR comes, so to ensure the quality and standard of the PR. So we have enforced that there should be tests, otherwise your PR cannot be merged. So Test Keeper actually keeps a track of if there are tests or if there are no tests for whatever change you are putting. There is a PR sanitizer that enforces certain rules for your PR. So it should start with a prefix like feed fix to actually categorize your PR if it is just a small fix or if it is a major feature kind of a thing. Also, the PR should have a description because somebody new who is contributing to a project does not have that. Another one rule that is there is that it should have a link to the issue that is there, because then that is easy. So once the PR is merged, the issue can be automatically closed there. So those are the checks that are there in PR Sanitizer. Work in Progress is just an enhanced version of the Work in Progress plugin that is already there in the PROW. And so this has definitely, significantly, we've seen that it has improved and enforced test coverage in our database. And if you want to check this out, you can go to our website, GitHub. It's again on GitHub, EEKPRO plugins. So you could either use, so this is also an open source project. If you think you want our version of Pro for these plugins, you can actually, again, you can send a request on our PR to us, and we can actually add your repository to our this. So that is how currently this is working. Or you can directly use the Kubernetes Prow for your use cases. So if you liked it, you can give a try. So the demo, that recording which I was showing, is available on YouTube. And that's it. There's a survey link if you can give a feedback there. That's it. Any questions? Questions? Yep.
Does this have any scalability limits? I mean, like, there's a certain number of pull requests that might be opened before the program crashes. Does this have any limitations from the scalability standpoint?
So are you talking from the Kubernetes project?
The whole PROW orchestration.
No, so PROW is, so it's depending on the webhook limits. So there are a lot of configurations that, like, I shared the link, so you can configure it. So I'm not aware of any limitation as such, because approximately, so I'm talking about, when we're talking about Kubernetes, I think most PR, that is the, like I said, mentioned, it's a very dynamic project, 100 PR, so it's working fine there. So if you have a project that is around the same limits, it should handle that very gracefully. Yeah. So you can always, so this is basically everything is Kubernetes behind, so there are pods, you can scale up, scale down, you can do all those kind of things. Any other questions? If no, I can hand over to Deepshika next. That's it. Thank you. And thank you all the organizers and everybody who helped behind this.